Hi, I'm Silo Lindsay. Welcome to worship with Lake Hills Presbyterian Church, USA. Before we start, we have a few announcements. Pretty much everything in the known universe can be found on our website, www.lakehillspres.org. Click Worship for Worship, Gather for gatherings like Sunday School and the Prayer Luncheon, click News for News, Give for online giving, and click Serve for serving the community of God. Today's Palm Sunday. It's the start of the Holy Week. We'll have a Monday-Thursday service Thursday night at 7 p.m. on the website. If you miss it, you can always go back and watch the replay on the website. Click Worship. Next Sunday is Easter. We will have a live stream of worship at 10:45 a.m. And we will celebrate communion online, so get ready. Have grape juice and bread nearby. Wherever you watch the live stream, when it comes time, we will share a drink of the cup and a piece of the bread together. On the website, click News for more news about Monday, Thursday, and Easter services. Remember the Wednesday prayer luncheon at noon on Wednesday. On the website, click Gather for more info. You can help make homemade face masks for doctors of humans and animals. To find out how, go to the website and click Serve. Let's worship God.
Hosanna! Wave it real big.
We thank you, God, for your goodness. Your love is everlasting. This is the gate of the Lord, and only the upright can enter. It was the stone which the builders rejected that became the keystone. This is God's doing, and it is wonderful to see. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us celebrate with joy.
Ooh.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Let's pray. Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart and mind and strength, and have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been, help us amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Anyone who is in Christ is a new creation. The old life has gone, a new life has begun. Know that you are forgiven and be at peace. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
Reading from Psalm 118. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteousness shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us, we beseech you, Lord. O Lord, O Lord, we beseech you. Give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the Aor. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, I will extol you. O, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. For his steadfast love endures forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning, boys and girls. I'm so glad to be with you today. Even though we're not at church, we can be together through video and technology. So normally on Palm Sunday at church, you would be given palm branches and you could walk through the sanctuary waving your palm branches as we sing a song about Hosanna. We can't do that this year, but we tried to make sure a lot of you got palm branches delivered to your homes so you could wave them at home and we could put them all together in a recording and show it to our other church members. So thank you all for doing that. That was a huge help. We're going to watch a little video in just a minute about the first Palm Sunday, but I wanted to set it up for you before you watch it. And I want to show you some pictures of things I want you to be watching for as you watch the video. Now, Palm Sunday was the first time that Jesus came into Jerusalem riding on a donkey. Now, the townspeople heard that Jesus was coming and there was going to be a big parade. And so they lined the streets and they got palm branches and they laid their coats out on the ground so that Jesus could march over the coats. And when you think of parade, you're probably thinking of big colored floats like what we see in today's parades. But Jesus actually came in on a donkey. And that's the first thing I want you to be watching for in the video, is to hear about the donkey that Jesus rode on Palm Sunday. The second thing I want you to be watching for are the palm branches. These are just like the ones you have at your house. And I want you to watch what the townspeople do with the palm branches and hear what they say when they wave the palm branches. And then the last thing I want you to be watching for are rocks. So in the video, there's a group of people and they don't like what Jesus is doing because he's taking the attention away from them. And they aren't the nicest in the world and they like the attention to be on themselves. And they scold Jesus and they say, "Why are you letting these people cheer for you this way? You need to make them be quiet." And Jesus says to them, "If I make these people stay quiet, the stones and rocks will shout out for me." So in the video that you're about to watch, I want you to listen for what they say about the rocks, the palm branches, and the donkey. So I hope you enjoy this telling of the very first Palm Sunday.
The story of Easter, the triumphal entry. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus and his disciples stopped in a town.
"You're coming?"
And Jesus told two of his disciples to go on ahead of them.
Okay.
He told them to go into a village and that they would see a young donkey that no one had ever ridden.
"Look!"
He told them to untie it and bring it to him. If anyone asks, "What are you doing?" he told them to just say, "The Lord needs it and will return it soon."
Okay, go ahead.
So the disciples did what Jesus said and brought him the donkey. A long time ago, before Jesus was even born, God had said that the Savior, the King of Israel, would come to Israel in this way. And now Jesus was doing just as God had said. The news that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem swept through the city. Many heard about all the amazing things he had done, so they cut palm branches and ran to see him.
Huh?
The Pharisees and religious rulers realized that there was nothing they could do, for everyone was going to see Jesus. Jesus rode into the city of Jerusalem, and the crowd spread their coats on the road ahead of him. His followers began to shout and sing as they walked along, praising God for all the wonderful miracles they had seen. The Pharisees were upset.
"Hey, Jesus!"
And they told Jesus to stop the people from saying things like that. But Jesus said, if they keep quiet, the stones along the road would burst into cheers. So the people kept on singing, "Blessings on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise God in highest heaven." The entire city of Jerusalem was in an uproar as he entered, asking, "Who is this?" And the crowds replied, "It's Jesus." And Jesus rode the donkey through the street of Jerusalem to the temple in a triumphal entry, just as God said he would many years before.
I hope you liked the video. Now, If you will bow your head with me, I want to say a prayer with you as we end our children's sermon. Dear God, thank you for saving us. Thank you for your work in our lives, even in unexpected ways. Help us to always praise your holy name. Thank you for loving us and for sending your son, Jesus. In his name we pray, amen. Thank you guys. I will hopefully see you next week.
We prayed for blessings, we prayed for peace, comfort for family, protection while we sleep. We pray for healing, for prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering. All the while, you hear each spoken need. Yet love is way too much to give us lesser things. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? We pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. We cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness, we doubt your love, as if every promise from your word is not enough. All the while, you hear each desperate plea, and long that we'd have faith to believe. 'Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? When friends betray us, when darkness seems to win, we know that pain reminds this heart that this is not our home. It's not our home. Cause what if your blessings come through raindrops? What if your healing comes through tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if my greatest disappointments or the aching of this life is the revealing of a greater thirst this world can satisfy? What if trials of this life, the rain, the storms, the hardest nights, are your mercies in disguise?
Today's scripture reading comes from Matthew chapter 21, verses 1 through 11. When they approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage on the Mount of Olives, Jesus gave two disciples a task. He said to them, "Go into the village over there. As soon as you enter, you will find a donkey tied up and a colt with it. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs it." He sent them off right away. Now this happens to fulfill what a prophet said. "Say to the daughter Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and riding on a donkey, and on a colt, the donkey's offspring." The disciples went and did just as Jesus had ordered them. They brought the donkey and the colt and laid their cloaks on them. Then he sat on them. Now a large crowd spread their cloaks on the road. Others cut off palm branches off the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds in front of him and behind him shouted, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessings on the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!" And when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred up. "Who is this?" they asked. The crowds answered, "It is Prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee."
How are you? I hope you're doing okay. I'm losing track of the days, and my sleep schedule is all messed up. What day is it? I guess it's Sunday. Is it day or is it night? Am I hungry? I don't know. We'll eat Oreos just in case. However, I will say that being at home altogether has definitely been the brightest spot in this darkness. Like the song Susan sang, sometimes the blessings come in disguise. There is nothing at all good about COVID-19. But if I have to be sheltering at home, I'm glad it's with Kristen and Emily and Anna. And of course, Bandit, our mutant Yorkie, is overjoyed that we're finally able to heap the attention on him that he deserves and demands. We're doing okay on toilet paper. It's dog treats we're really running out of. I hope wherever you are, whether you're with family or by yourself, you are safe, you are healthy, and you are getting by. This can be a very lonely time, a scary time. Yes, we're slowing down. Yes, we're noticing the daily blessings and the daily bread in our lives. A phone call, a video chat, a neighbor tapping on a window and waving hello. These are small things, but when you're missing them, they are daily bread, feasts that can fill us up one bite at a time. Holy Week, this coming week, is usually kind of dark. Think of all the things we talk about during Holy Week. A Last Supper, betrayed by friends, the fickle crowds, denial, sweat of blood, death, crucifixion. You can't get to Easter without going through the cross. At least, that's what the church says. Maundy Thursday, Good Friday, they're dark. They're intentionally sad days. The season of Lent that we came through is supposed to be a little sad. In so many ways, the church and the world have synced up far more than we want it. It's a season of sad. This Holy Week, in the year of our Lord 2020, the year of coronavirus, we've got the sad part down. We've got the suffering and isolation down. This year, we are suffering right along with Christ, and Jesus is suffering right along with us. So it's ironic that this week starts with a bright parade. Hosanna, Hosanna, the little children sing. That's the blessing. But there's also a warning that comes with Palm Sunday. The warning is that in the back of our minds, we know what's coming in the week ahead in the life of Christ. We know the feelings. We know the emotional roller coaster that's Holy Week. Do you feel like you're on an emotional roller coaster these days? Do you feel like you're seesawing between happy and sad a little too fast to take in? If so, I'd say you get Holy Week the way it was intended. I don't know if that makes you happy, but it might make you feel exceptionally normal. Holy Week was not a normal week. In some parts it was wonderful, in some parts it was horrific. But the church, in its wisdom, declared this week holy, with all its ups and downs. Holy. Our times are not normal. Our days, our weeks are not normal. But those are the kind of week God takes and makes holy, whether we know it or not. You remember the kids' song, "If You're Happy and You Know It"? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. Clapping hands, the international symbol for people who are happy and know it. Which raises the deep question, what if you're happy and you don't know it? Is that even possible? And if so, shouldn't these people have a signal too? What would it be? Rubbing your chin? Wait, no, don't touch your face. If you're happy and you don't know it, would you even know how to show it? The people of Jerusalem were really happy Jesus was there. Maybe they clapped their hands, we don't know. They waved palm branches. We Presbyterians don't clap, but we will wave shrubbery. We're biblical that way. People who are really happy, all together, have parades. And there have been a lot of parades lately, not the normal kind, not the kind where people line the streets and wave or clap their hands, but the kind where well-wishers drive past a house in a caravan of cars, the kind where newlyweds poke their heads out the sunroof and wave like William and Kate to their royal subjects. Yes, we are married now. Please be festive. Remain 6 feet apart. We can be so creative when we're cooped up for a couple of weeks. Parade people are happy, and they know it. If Jesus rode into our city today, how would the parade look? With everyone at home for the good of the nation, for the future of the church, how would the Palm Sunday parade look for Jesus today? Here's one of my favorite internet memes from the past week. It's so descriptive of Holy Week in 2020. It's Leonardo's The Last Supper, brilliantly photoshopped onto, of course, the screen of a MacBook laptop. There's Jesus at the table all by himself. There's a bottle of hand sanitizer beside him. The rest of the table is totally empty. It's all Jesus alone. But up above Jesus are the Zoom windows of the apostles connecting remotely to the meeting. Whoever came up with this was a genius. If Jesus had the Last Supper today, this is how he'd have to have it. If the Palm Sunday parade happened today, would it be streamed to YouTube or to Facebook Live? Would the sidewalks be empty? Would the palm branches be sprayed down with Lysol, if you can find it? Would we have to video our kids waving branches and shouting Hosanna? Guess so. And how would we, sitting in our homes, feel about watching it on our devices? Would we be happy? Would we know it? I don't know if you've been to a grocery store lately, Walmart or Target. We try to wait as long as possible and let the shopping list really accumulate. In my mind, I make a shopping strategy and an exit strategy. I see people coming and I cross to the other side of the aisle, but I smile and nod because I want to be friendly. I'm also afraid they might be potentially carrying COVID-19. It's the ones who stand in the middle of the aisle and don't move when you come by that really irritate the fire out of me. Do you not watch the news? So I press myself against the canned vegetables and shimmy past. I find I'm getting very judgmental about who I think might be a carrier and who I think looks healthy. I'm not proud of that. I also know I'm probably wrong, because given incubation times, the healthy people are the ones you have to watch out for. Another reason I stay away from Whole Foods. We get judgmental, and we hardly even know it. We're on high alert, but we really don't want to show it. Our brains are on guard for what we can't see and what we don't know is coming around the corner. That's caveman stuff. Friend or foe, fight or flight. Our physical stress levels are elevated. The bodies that we have, the physical bodies that we live in, cut down the oxygen to the rational, reasonable parts of our brains so the primal parts can be set to armed. I don't know if you can be happy and not know it, but we can all be stressed out and not know it. We might not even show it. In weird or angry responses, suspicions, depression, what's triggering us? Oh, pretty much everything. But God knows us. God knows us. Jesus is fully God and fully human. So God knows how this feels. Jesus knows how it feels to one day be happy with happy followers who know it. And Jesus knows how it feels the next day, the next hour, the next minute. He knows how it feels to be scared of what we don't know might be coming. I don't know what might be coming this week. One New York doctor on TV called his ER hell. Things may well get unholy. They did for Jesus, too. As Jesus sets his eyes toward Jerusalem, he would soon set his eyes on the cross. And yet, what he saw, what he went through, was made holy. Made holy in the redemptive, eternal love of God. God makes our days holy too. God makes us holy. Holy means of God. God makes us holy. We might not know it. We might look and feel like an unholy mess, but God makes us holy. How might that song go now? If you're holy and you know it, clap your hands. Wash your hands, stomp your feet, say amen. I don't know what the signal would be. You get to pick. But if you're holy and you know it, if you're of God and you get it, then you really do need to show it. Show it in prayer. Show it in acts of compassion to your neighbors. Show it in silly waving, honking parades on somebody's birthday. Put a roll of toilet paper on your neighbor's porch. But if you don't know it, if you don't feel or you don't want to hear how God has already declared you holy, that's okay. I really doubt Jesus felt all that holy as he was praying alone in the Garden of Gethsemane, praying so hard, the Bible says, his sweat became like drops of blood. Such a short time from the happy Palm Sunday parade. In our stress and in our sadness, there may not be happiness, but there is holiness. It is there. It can be found. I pray you have a happy day today and tomorrow, and as many days as come. But I also pray that your sadness, when it bubbles up, that your stress, when it starts to boil, I pray that even the dark parts of your week will help you know your own holiness and the holiness of everyone 6 feet away.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
During these times of uncertainty and isolation, we ask you to give as you are able, that the church can continue its ministries. You can give online or by mailing a check to the church office. Instructions for online giving are at www.lakehillspres.org/give. This is a secure system that allows you to use a credit card. Yours, O Lord, are grandeur and power, majesty, splendor, and glory. All in the heavens and on the earth is yours, and of your own we give you.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be and abide with you today and forevermore. Amen.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna.